Nice going, lover boy.
Hey.
Did you enjoy yourself?
What do you mean?
Will Christmas come a little early this year, Tom?
What? You got a little something in your hair there. Oh, yeah.
Relax. It's all good. I mean, I got no choice, right? It's the way it's gonna be. I gotta face the facts. I'm dead. I ain't never coming back. She looks good, though. First time in forever, she's happy.
Yeah.
Satisfied. Sleeping through the night. Damien's as safe as any guy could be on the job, right? By the way, Chief is right. Damien should definitely be paired up with Lou.
Yeah.
You can't focus on him all the time. You got enough asses to cover at that house.
Yeah.
Any firefighter with a brain under his helmet should know that.
I'm glad you said that. That's pretty close to what I, you know, I would have said. So you're cool.
It's all good. It's all good.
Good. All right, see you later.
Whoa. Where you going?
Probably go down a bar, have a, you know.
No, you gotta go down there and tell her, right?
No. She's asleep.
Yeah, but you gotta go down and tell her.
I told her I was gonna make a sandwich and then, you know, and then lock up. Which, you know, we have a deal.
I don't stay home, Tom. She's a woman. What she says and what she really wants never really matches up, right?
Yeah.
So what you gotta do is you gotta go down there, tell her about Damien being with Lou now.
Yeah. I'm not gonna do that, bro.
See you later. You're not leaving, Tom. You're not leaving until you go down there, lay down next to her, spoon with her, and tell her the
truth.
Wait, whoa.
Did you say spoon?
I said spoon.
I don't spoon.
I know. No. I said spoon, you're gonna spoon.
Not. Spoon.
You okay. Will spoon. So, no. You're gonna spoon with her like you work at a Baskin Robbins. Do you understand me?
I'm not doing it.
Okay. Get down there. Get down. Get your ass in there, lover boy.
I'm going.
Go.
Okay.
Right out here if you need me.
Great. I'm not spooning. I'm another day. Come on.
Would you like red and green peppers or just red?
You know, whatever. Whatever, it's, you know.
Whatever?
I meant, you know, whatever you're chopping there. It's great. Everything's good. It's all good. What? No, chill. Listen. Sheila, what? I never thought about that. Hey.
Morning, sunshine.
What did I say? What did
you say? First of all, you said fluffy. Then you said whatever when she asked you about red or green peppers. Well, what you should have said was either, oh, both would be fantastic, baby, or almost immediately, you treat me so goddamn good, as you snuggled up behind her and gave her a great big hug. But you didn't. It's okay. But let's forget about the peppers for a moment. I need to know, when are you gonna tell her about the new situation with Damien? Because, by the way, as I told you, I'm fine with it, because I love Lou. I trust Lou. I figure between you and Lou and the pussy, Damien's dynamite.
Which pussy?
Which pussy? What do you mean? You know, the kid with the hair and the skin creams.
Celetti.
Whatever. The point is, I know Damien's in good hands, all right? But you better let her know now, goddammit. What?
Whatever. Oh, shit, it's her. Hey, do you... Listen, that shit she was talking about at the beach.
No. She told me about it. Long, long time ago. Gotta admit, cuz, you are a goddamn caveman.
That's funny. Especially coming from Captain Com, Mr. Dependable over here.
Now, you're right. That was me. Mr. Always Where I Was Supposed to Be. Even on September 11th. Yeah, maybe that's why the marriage gave way. Maybe she was just bored of me. Hell, when I was on the wagon, I even bored the shit out of myself.
Who'd you sleep with?
Don't you worry about it.
All right. was it someone I knew?
That plasma ain't gonna hang itself.
Jesus Christ.
Shit.
Psst. Hey, it wasn't Janet, by the way. In case you were wondering. Yeah, just thought I'd tell you. What'd you think, I was a scumbag like you? And listen, regardless, whatever I did, or whatever reasons I might have had, I never would have slept with Janet if the tide was reversed. You know what I mean? Like, if you died in World Trade Center instead of me, Sheila and me, we might have been said and done with. Who knows? No way I would have slept with your old lady. That's just me. Okay? Code of honor, cuz. The brotherhood, right?
Yeah.
By the way, you ought to take the deal Sheila's offering. Take it and run with it. Because the two of you are going to end up killing each other either way. Might as well go out with that great big goddamn blaze of glory.
Hey, Jimmy. Hey.
Yeah?
Nothing.
So much to look forward to. The week I got hit. That Saturday, you remember? It's gonna be my Little League All-Star game. Mom, making you take off work. You miss a bunch of my games that summer. You're working on that overtime. Jimmy. makes such a good firefighter.
I'd give anything to be there when he graduates from the academy. One thing I'm happy for, though, is that my kid didn't die before me. If he did, that'd make my heart ache so much. I would never, ever be able to get over it.
Me either. You know, it's just it's like a silver lining on a never-ending dark cloud. You know, Connor, when you died, it was just, it was so meaningless, you know, it was so unnecessary. I don't know, I had your whole life laid out in front of you at your feet, falling in love, having your own kids. I don't know how you deal with it, Tommy. It must be killing you inside. Have another drink, bro. You're almost there. Just one more drink. One more and the dam's gonna burst, brother. I promise.
You ain't gonna make a lick of difference. You can drink all the booze he wants. Drain the goddamn bar dry. Won't matter a bit. Ain't no tears inside them bottles. Or any left behind those blue Irish eyes. He cried them all when Connor got crushed. Same way I did when Johnny here got clipped. I heard the news, went in the can and shed a few. Came right back out to face the music. Face the music, assholes. He's done. Dead as a doornail inside. Just like me. Only he's still walking around. That's why he's the best goddamn firefighter there ever will be. Better than I was. Better than Jimmy was. Because the only thing he can feel is heat. Only thing that gets through that thick Irish skin of his is fire. And even goddamn flames ain't gonna make him cry. He's the real deal. Iron Man. Come to life.
Jimmy!
Bad dream?
Yeah.
They're pink, by the way. My balls. In case you were still wondering.
They're supposed to be pink.
Perfect.
Jesus Christ. You got nothing to say to me? No? Okay. Just wanted to drop by to make sure you knew that... Well, I wasn't lying to you when I told you I wouldn't have slept with Janet. You know, after 9/11, if you had died instead of me, I just wouldn't. Especially since, well, seeing as how I already had her.
Everything all right?
Yeah.
You need a hand?
No.
Hey, come on.
Nah, busy.
This gun here with 5 empty chambers in 1 round. So the odds are stacked pretty much in my favor. But why don't we all just leave it to fate? You want to do the honors, Tom?
I tell you, I really don't.
I didn't think so. Oh, Jesus Christ, 5 empty chambers. I hit him with the first shot. Why can't I get those kind of results when I'm playing the goddamn lottery?
Teddy, what? Oh, shit!
There was another bullet in there. I swear I think I'm coming down with the goddamn Alzheimer's.
Teddy, goddammit, what are you doing?
I said I had 1 round in that gun. Sorry, 2.
It's okay, cuz. You'll see when you get here. All makes sense on the other side.
The army of forgotten souls.